兄弟，今儿有事吗？哦，今儿晚上有酒局啊！算我一个，算我一个。哎，你们几个人啊？八个人。哎，那你几辆车啊？
儿啊，
哎，
你帮我看看，
啊，
这说的是什么呀？马东什么？
啊，对啊，马冬梅，马冬梅。哦哦，没事没事没事。哦，两辆车还行。去哪儿啊？哦，那家 KTV 呀，啊，哎，那个，地儿我知道，地儿好，妞贼。哎，对了对了，那个就我特别喜欢的那个小姐姐，身材特别好，那个去不去？
你再帮我看看这是什么冬梅，
啊，马冬梅，马冬梅，
啊，
没事没事，我妈没事，就我特别喜欢那小姐姐，去不去啊？哦，她也来，那感情不错哈，哦。哎，跟你说，今天这酒局咱可得好好安排一下，知道吧？一会儿啊，我跟你说，把青瓷也拉上，你先来接我，我去接青瓷。知道吗？咱三个路上好好合计合计。
马什么梅？你再跟我说一遍。
马冬梅，马冬梅，好好合计合计。哎呀，我跟你说，今儿晚上啊，就看你们俩帮我安排了，知道吗？这小姐姐我可喜欢了。哎，行，这样，一会儿路上聊啊。这样啊，挂了。
这个人到底叫啥呀？
哎呀，马冬梅，马冬梅啊！跟你说多少次了？
妈妈抱抱。妈妈，这是什么呀？
那个是车子呀。
那妈妈，这个是什么呀？
这个也是车子呀。
那妈妈，这个又是什么呀？
这些都是车子呀。
喂，兄弟，今儿晚上的酒局我就不去了吧。我才发现我有好几年没和我妈一起过圣诞节了。
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, all seated onShone around. Hail, chime on, chime on. Merry, merry Christmas bells, chime on. Hail, chime on, chime on. Merry, merry Christmas bells, chime on.
妈，刚才不好意思啊。今年圣诞节我陪您过。走，我带您去吃圣诞大餐去。
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, all seated on, all on the ground, the angel of the Lord came down, and glory shone around. Hail, chime on, chime on.
up, Kev?
Hey. You ready for tonight, man?
Yeah.
Yo, like, you know, last night was dope, bro. Yeah. Yo, so how about Ted? Did you tell Ted to come?
I told him he should be here soon.
Okay, he's taking mad long, though.
Yeah. Yo, that's Ted right there. Yo, what's up, man?
What's
it take so long, bro?
Sorry.
Did you tell John to come?
Yes, I did. I think he will be here.
Okay. He better be here, because like last night he dished me. Oh, man.
Yeah, guys, you know, last night was dope, but like the girl, man,
hey,
she was
Ted,
so...
Hey,
what's up?
What's up? Yo, you guys ready for the party tonight? Yeah, you guys ready? Woo, let's go!
Oh, why the fuck is he here, yo? I thought we told John to come, not Josh, yo. No, I'm not gonna go out with him tonight, man. Yo, let's just talk to Ted. Yo, Ted, can I talk to you for a second? We should invite John, not Josh.
He's John.
No, he's Josh.
Really?
Yeah, look at him. Look at his moves, yo. John never do this kind of shit, yo.
Yo, but we still need him to spend money.
Yes, besides his dance move, he's a good person.
Whatever, man. Let's just go.
Josh, let's go.
Hello. Hey, what's up?
What's up? Wait!
It was Josh's phone, not ours.
Wow, okay. Anyway, let the party begin.
Cheers!
Wait, so what was the rule again?
Ace's drink.
Okay.
Okay.
He took my card.
Sure.
So.
This one. Oh, Ace.
Yo, why? Drink. No, that was supposed to be my card.
Well, Ace's drink.
Hey guys, I got an ace too.
Oh. Wait, what do you think you're doing?
I got an ace.
No. You're drinking this, not that.
Okay,
thank you. Guys, look at this. I'm gonna make it drink. Where's Josh?
Yeah.
Where?
Spencer, I got you. Don't worry. You'll be fine. Okay. Guys, you can let go. This happened to my friend before. These papers will hold them. We'll go back to normal. Don't worry.
What is this? What are you guys doing? What just happened?
Josh just saved you.
Wait, Josh?
Yeah, you're possessed.
Possessed?
Possessed.
My head hurts.
It's okay. You'll be okay now.
Thanks, man. I was wrong about you.
Alright, there you go, man.
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I hit rock bottom, and I needed something. I was sick and tired of feeling down, and I just felt sad all the time. It all started after I broke up with him. We had a very intense relationship from the beginning, and then it just took a really dark turn for me. Things ended and it broke me. I didn't really know how to cope with my emotions at that point in my life. I'd just gone off to university and was having the best time. But in the midst of being happy amongst other people, when I was alone, I couldn't do anything. I never really felt good enough, not for anyone, which just trickled down into different aspects of my life. I started to realise it was all to do with my family. My dad left when I was 3. I guess that triggered these feelings. So whenever anything went wrong in my love life, this feeling of not being good enough was heightened. I felt that whenever I tried to be better to myself, there was always this voice telling me, "You're not good enough." I remember the times when my mum made me call him, my dad, and he'd promised me he would come back to the UK and raise me, and it was just all these empty promises and these lies throughout my whole childhood. After a while, you just stop trusting people. When everything went down with my ex, it brought back a lot of emotions which I had repressed. I couldn't run from them anymore, and it got really bad. I thought about suicide. I never really wanted to end my life. I just knew that I was exhausted by it. It was hard, just every day, feeling like I was getting nowhere. And just finding almost comfort in the sadness. I realised after a while that you can get addicted to a certain kind of sadness. Eventually I started painting. I guess that was the first time I used it as a form of therapy. When I started painting, it was all very rash, it was very expressive. I didn't think about what was happening. It was just the process of brush, paint, canvas. I then bought a sketchbook and carried that with me everywhere I went. It just became my best friend. It was my diary. It wasn't even canvas half the time. It would be cardboard off of the street, anything I could get my hands on, really. It gave me a break from thinking too much.
Future, I'm hoping to do my mom. master's, get in art psychotherapy, and help others, I guess, as cringy as it sounds. That's cute.
$200? I don't got that kind of money. What the fuck, Mariah?
Looks like we're asking Mom. Let's see. Hey, Mom, do you think you could buy me $200 Mariah Carey tickets as a
early Christmas? How the fuck did she know?
Yo, what's up, bro?
Yo.
How you doing?
I'm good. How you doing?
Terrible, man. I really want to go to the stupid Mariah Carey concert, but I don't have any money.
Yo, I know how it feels. I used to be broke, too.
So how did you get unbroke?
I'm selling stuff.
What kind of stuff?
Yo, I trust you, so don't go telling nobody, but I'm selling pods and coke.
Are you serious?
Yeah, man. How do you think I got that new car? If you want in, I could put you on.
I don't know, man. It seems kind of weird. I don't even know if this is risky or not, but...
I'll give you some days to think about it, but I gotta know ASAP.
Alright, deal. I'll catch you later and I'll let you know. Is it illegal to sell Tide Pods? Alright. Is it illegal to sell Coca-Cola? Alright. We're good.
Hello? Yeah, I'm in. Alright, cool. Thanks. Bye.
Make my wish come true. All I want for Christmas is you.
Ayo, listen. This concert's coming up in a couple days. I need $5. Explain yourself.
Yo, calm down, bro. You an idiot for trying to sell detergent and coke like it's drugs. I've been getting money with my uncle from construction. That's just the stuff I had in my bag that day. I was just trying to fuck with you.
Yo, what the fuck? Are you serious?
Don't worry, bro. I felt bad for making you look stupid this past week. Merry early Christmas.
No way.
And guess who's going to the concert with you?
You're a fucking dick, you know that? I love you though. Thank you, bro.
Hi, my name is Rich Ashu. I work for Chris City Supermarket Change. I became a program manager when I was 18. I met with a company owner, and he asked me to try to be a program manager, which is a union job. Pay was very good at that time, so I took it. I see retired people. I also see millennial kids. They spend more and they like to buy prepack, ready made, and pay more money. I see mostly older people, they buy the old traditional way, look for a right writers, look things. Millennia, they don't think, they just spend it. Retail business is very rough right now, very competitive, especially coming with the online marketing. We are losing a lot of business. Right now, they come into the whole grocery online marketing. They become clothing. Everything become online. It's very hard to survive. But they have the overhead. The rent is very expensive. Employees, you have to use more employees. Everything is very expensive. So very hard to survive on retail business these days. We have to bring more promotion, more sales. So we have to buy cheap. We need a better customer service for everybody. Grocery industry being affected too. Right now, Amazon take over Whole Foods. Walmart has their own grocery business. Target has a grocery business too. First that I have a grocery business. Almost the supermarket doing it online, big supermarket. Stop and Shop have a shop online business too. So we really are struggling for the business. Some people, they like to go into the store, pick their own. They like to spend time on the store. Especially older people, they like to talk to the employees in the store. Most of the people know each other. We know most of the customer who come in it, like every other day, every week. We know who shop in the store, what they buy. After work, they come and grab and go session most of the time. They're not for cooking. They mostly for dinner, grab and go, fruit cup, salad. These days, online shopping, they deliver it for free. More convenient, easy to find, save time, so it saves money too. Prices, you can compare and look online. Advantage retail, I would say, right now, really not much, but we're struggling right now in the retail business compared with online. We're losing, actually. Before online shopping, we do very well. We do a lot more business. Everybody coming, we buy a lot of more buying power, more customers. The rent is cheap, labor is cheap. Right now, the rent is very expensive, the labor expenses. But online, they cut a lot of overhead. I hope is everybody should come back to the retail business, the shop. But one day, they might get bored online. They might come back to the store and shop like a regular shop. Do shopping one day, hopefully.
Luz!
Local law enforcement officials are perplexed and bemused at the fact that the killer still remains at large and incredibly dangerous. Elusive and also evading any sort of description, nobody has been able to provide to the police departments any sort of graphical or pictorial depiction of the person in question. The victims are four young women, and their remains are currently being identified. It is quite a gruesome sight. But perhaps the most perplexing part of this entire event is the fact that the killer is engaging in these events at and around a parking garage near a mall. Security cameras can't capture him, no one seems to be able to hear him, and hence he has earned his moniker, Obscuro.
Look, I'll be home in a little while, okay?
Well, what are you gonna do? Come pick me up? My car is here. There's no point.
I seriously don't